Hello, welcome. Today, I'm going to introduce one of the most requested apps by viewers on this channel in recent times, fpPS4, a software that allows you to run PlayStation 4 games. Before I share my experience with this app and decide whether it's worth testing or not, please remember to leave a like to support the channel. And if you're new here, subscribe to get the latest updates every week.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Let's start by talking about the installation of this application. Unfortunately, due to the restricted nature of this content on the platform, I can't detail the process here, but I'll provide a video link in the description that explains how to make it work. However, I must emphasize that it's not a straightforward process and likely won't be worth the effort. As for the app itself, the last update was in December 2022, which means it's been more than 10 months since then. The app lacks a graphical interface, so you'll need to install other complementary apps to make it work correctly. Additionally, it's not capable of natively running ISO or PKG files. This implies that you'll have to dump your own games one by one and often deal with encrypted files. So far, the software can only run 2D games, though it's challenging to claim that they truly run. I conducted tests with 10 games, of which 8 were listed as playable in the compatibility list. However, I managed to get only 2 of those games to run, and even then, the results were not excellent. The game Shantae and the Pirate's Curse, which should be listed as playable, actually runs at only 8 FPS. Sonic Mania, on the other hand, struggles to maintain an average above 40 FPS. Essentially, to inflate the compatibility list, they consider anything that can run as playable, regardless of the actual speed at which the game is running. Additionally, there are no options like resolution settings, for example. There's only one option to customize controls. Speaking of controls, here's another issue. In software that runs PlayStation 4 games, nothing would be better than using a DualShock 4 controller, right? However, the software doesn't have the capability to handle these controllers and only works with controllers that use the X Input API. When running games, I also noticed that there's something wrong with how it renders the sprites of 2D games. If you look closely, you'll notice all the blocks that make up the sprite, making everything look even more pixelated. Furthermore, I checked the project's Discord, and many 2D games that people manage to run are running at a rate of about 7 to 12 FPS, making them completely unplayable. Unfortunately, this wasn't the news I was hoping to deliver. I thought that 2D games would at least run decently, but so far, they only reach 60 FPS in menus. While there are several videos talking about incredible progress and mentioning games like Bloodborne, the software takes several minutes just to reach the menu. I believe it may take many years for simpler games to become fluid and truly playable. Fortunately, there are other ongoing projects for the PlayStation 4, including 11 in total. However, at this moment, there's still nothing that can truly do the basics, which is running games, whether they are 2D or 3D. Until the next video.